I'm going to talk about a joint work with Chuck Weibel. So it's a work in progress, but I think all proofs are written now, so we can claim that all results we say are true, we hope. Maybe I should start with what is K-theory. And of course, the name of K-theory is related to Alexandre Grothendieck. Who died this month. And I want to dedicate this lecture to him because he was partly my thesis advisor with Henri Carton. And I have a great admiration for him. Okay, so what is Very short, what is K-theory? Well, you start with X, for example, the complex algebraic variety. And Grothendieck defined a group, which is called K of X, as follows. He takes the free abelian group generated by vector bundles, E. And it takes a relation that each time you have an exact sequence of vector bundles, then the middle term is identified with the extreme terms. Of course, this is took this definition because it's related with Riemann-Roch theorem. Well, it's an old story. And shortly after, Attia and Hirzebruch define a topological analog, which is called Ku of X, this topological K theory. And of course, there is a relation, of course, with the same type of identities, except that exact sequences split in the topological case. We start with topological vector bundles instead of algebraic vector bundles. And there is a map from K of X to Ku of X, which can be looked at as a Cartesian class if you want, but which is far too anisomorphism. You lose a lot of information by going from algebraic to this algebraic case theory to topological case theory. Over my emphasis today is about real algebraic varieties. And of course, Grothendieck definition works as well for a real algebraic variety. In fact, it defined K theory for a scheme. So we can define K of X as well if X is a real algebraic variety. And now you can ask, what is a topological analog? And in fact, you have two candidates. One, which is the KO theory of the space of real points. So in other words, if you take an algebraic vector bundle, you take its restriction to the real space of real points, and then you look at it as a topological vector bundle. So this is called KO theory. And but there is another candidate, which was invented by Attia, which is KR theory, topological KR theory, which is more subtle than taking the space of real points. Because, for example, if you take a real algebraic variety, the space of real points can be empty. And then you get nothing. Okay? So the idea of Attia is to take a space X, a compact space, for example, topological space, with involution. He calls this a real space with a capital R. And he considers a category of topological vector bundle on X, but complex vector bundles. So it's a complex vector bundles But you have an extra structure, which is the fact that you have, for each point on the space, you have a map from the fiber at the point X to the fiber at the point conjugate, which is called X bar. So let's call X goes X bar the involution of the space. And this tau X is antilinear. And tau X square equal 1. Okay, so when you compose, and you get 1. So it calls this a real vector bundle. And he showed that this map, so the K-theory of this category mimicking Grothendieck construction is called K-R-theory. And what Atiyah shows is that this map, which is a naive map, can be factorized through K-R of X. So in other words, K-R of X is more subtle invariant than K-O of X-R. If you don't like this definition, you can have another one which is equivalent. You take the Banach algebra, the A of functions from X to C, such that F of X-bar equal F of X-bar, and we can show that K-R of X is just the Grothendieck group K0 of the ring A. So in other words, you take Plantagenet's projective module over this ring, and you get a category which is equivalent to the category of real vector bundles in the sense of Atiyah. Okay. So now there is something you can do much better than that, is to construct a spectrum. There is a spectrum of both algebraic K-theory, I call capital K of X, and topological K-theory. And then you have two candidates, KU is a complex case, and KR is a real case. And the homotopy groups of these spectrums by n of k of x are the algebraic k groups of Quillen, which we defined about 40 years ago. And the homotopy groups, say, of kr of x are krn, also defined by Atiyah. Maybe I should put a top to emphasize there are topological KR groups, and these are periodic of period 8. And this is about periodicity. And of course, what I said on the level of groups, you can do on the level of spectrum, of spectra. You have a map from the algebraic K3 spectrum, K of X. So X is now real algebraic variety. To the spectrum of topological KR theory. Okay. And this induces a map from Quillen K groups to topological K groups. If you don't like spectra, you can define, for example, KRN, as usual, equivalent definition. KRN of X is essentially KR of the nth dimension of X plus, where, well, you put a tilde. It's actually the nth dimension of X. What? No, no, no. I don't put involution here. SN is a sphere without involution. If you take an involution, antipodal involution, then you get, yeah, maybe it's a good remark that if you, you can also define KRN for N negative, but I don't want to go into this picture now. In fact, you can define, following Atiyah, groups KPQ, relative groups, but I don't want to go into the technicalities here. But I want to emphasize one deep theorem, which is the following. Of course, you want to compare algebra and topology. Okay? So you want to compare the spectrum of algebraic K-theory to the spectrum of topological K-theory. Again, I put a top to emphasize the dependence. So X is here. Maybe I have not defined, in fact, what is this map exactly, because when I say real vector bundles going to in the sense, usual sense, to real vector bundles in the sense of Atiyah, it's clear if you take this definition, for example, if you have, for example, just make a short here, if you have a R of X1, Xn divided by an ideal, then this is an algebraic function on a fine manifold, then you can view this complex function which takes conjugate values on conjugate points. Okay, so it's obvious, this map is obvious on this example. And it's obvious in general. So anyway, you have this Cartesian map from algebra to topology, and the way to compare them is to introduce a relative spectrum, which I call K relative. So in other words, you have an exact sequence with Kn of X, Krn of X, and the homotopy group of this fiber, which is Kn relative, and so on. And one theorem, a deep theorem, which was mainly proved by Vrevolsky, Rost, Weibel, and a little bit myself, but the main work has been done by Vrevolsky and Rost, is that in fact, these groups are infinitely visible groups. So in other words, if n is bigger or equal to d minus 2, where d is the dimension of x, then the groups Kn rel are uniquely infinitely divisible. This is a deep theorem using motivic homology and so on. Okay? So that's a very deep theorem. It shows that K theory with finite coefficients is the same as topological K theory with finite coefficients for n large enough. Okay? This related to Lichtenbaum-Kullin conjecture.
Okay.
Thomasson also, yes. Yeah. There are many people who contribute to this, but the final touch has been done by Vrevolsky and Rost. Okay. Maybe I shall put. Yeah, if you take a complex manifold, then you take Ku here instead of Kr. But it's still true, yes. Okay. Okay, but now I want to, so this is K theory. Okay? And now I want to introduce another theory, which is, which are not considered by Grothendieck, but by people working on quadratic forms, which is Hermitian K-theory. So what is Hermitian K-theory? The idea is to consider vector bundles E with a symmetric non-degenerate bilinear form. So from the point of view of Lie groups, instead of taking a general linear group, you take something like the orthogonal group. Okay? And you want to mimic Grothendieck definition. So what you do is the following. First, I should give an example of such a bundle. If you start with L, with a usual bundle, and you take E equal L plus its dual, it's obviously a symmetry bilinear form, just intertwining and L star. And this is called the hyperbolic module, or hyperbolic vector bundles. Hyperbolic bundle. And now you put the following relation. If you take an L, a subbundle in a bundle F, then you want to identify F with H. You assume that L orthogonal, L is included in L orthogonal. Then you want to identify F with L orthogonal divided by L plus H of L. So you put this relation. And I define the Grothendieck Witt group H of L is this. Sorry. So it's called the hyperbolic module. Yes. What? Yes, yes. So. Okay. And the rotating bit group GW of X is a free group generated by modules, by bundles with symmetric bilinear forms divided by this relation. And this is a Grothendieck Witt group. Okay. And of course, this is well known from people working on quadratic forms. Maybe I shall define also the Witt group. You have a map from K of X to GW of X, which simply send L to H of L. Okay. And the co-kernel is called the Witt group. So V is called the Witt group. Okay, so the Grothendieck Witt group is a mixture of Witt definition and Grothendieck definition, of course. And maybe this Witt group is very important in recent work. Maybe I shall quote a very famous Minor conjecture. Now proved, it's no longer a conjecture, it's a theorem, which is the following. You start with X. So X here was almost everything. Okay, you can take the spectrum of a field, for example, like K, not necessarily complex or real. And then the Witt group of X is classically called the Witt group of a field. That's a classical Witt group. The definition for the field is just Z. For it's the exact sequence. It's defined by the co-kernel of the map from K of X. No. So if you take the spectrum of a field, for example, then K of a field is not very interesting. It's just Z. Okay? So it's just Z going to GW by a Bayesian notation, K, and then W of K. Instead of this case, the Witt group is not interesting. Okay. And you have an augmentation to Z mod 2, which sends a vector space to its dimension mod 2. And the co-kernel, the kernel, is called the augmentation ideal. Okay. A minor conjecture says that if you take the power of this ideal, the quotient of two successive powers, in divided by n plus 1, that is homomorphic to the Galois cohomology, Hn, with Z mod 2 quotients. This Galois cohomology. Okay. And this conjecture was proved by Wojewodzki. And I think Vichik also, yes? And there is another conjecture of Minor, saying that this group is also the so-called Minor K groups, K and Minor of K, another K theory, and this was proved by Wojewodzki. Mode 2, sorry, yes. Yeah, so thank you. Okay, so this is a classical invariant for fields. But what about real varieties now? Well, let's come back. I come back to my main interest, which is real algebraic varieties, and to see if we can prove something analogous to Voivodsky theorem. Okay, so of course one need to define, the first thing to do is to define topological analog. Of GW of X and W of X. And there are obvious candidates, which is Atia, you take Atia category, Atia's category of real vector bundles. This is what we call an Hermitian category. In other words, of course, if you have a real vector bundle, then its dual is also a real vector bundle. And so you can define a notion of bilinear form the same way. You have a map from E to its dual, which is symmetric, etc. Okay? And so you can define GR of X to be the Grothendieck V group of the category of real vector bundles, real in the sense of a tier. Okay. And in fact, it's not too hard to check that this is just as a theorem or lemma. This is computable. In fact, this GR of X is just equivariant K theory, KOG of X, where G is a group Z mod 2. Why? Because if you think a little bit, you have a real vector bundle plus a symmetric bilinear form. Okay, but it's well known that if you have the supergroup is UN, ON, ONC, but ONC has a differentiable retract with the usual orthogonal group. So any real vector bundle with a symmetric bilinear form can be viewed as a real vector bundle in the usual sense. And now you have the action of Z mod 2, which gives you an equivalent vector bundle. No, here X is a compact. X here is any space. Any space. Well, we can make it more general, but any space. Any space. No, not for. So if you take an algebraic, okay. So if you take X, if you take X a real algebraic variety, then you take its complex points, and you take GR of its complex point, which is KOG of XC. XC, not XR.
KOG of X.
KOG of XC. Yeah, okay, you're right. KOG of XC, yes. So this group is computable. Okay. So this is GR of X. And the V group, which I call WR of X, is just a co-kernel of the map from KR of X to KOG of X. Because when you start with a real vector bundle in the sense of a tier, you forget the capital R, and you put a small r, it's a real vector model without capital R, but then you can, you have the action of Z mod 2. Okay? And so you have a Kersey class from KR to KOG. And the co-kernel of this map is just an analog of the V group, the topological context. Okay. So far we have just given definitions. So let's state a theorem. Of course, a question, if you remember, I said before that a map from K of X to come back to Grothendieck to KU of X is far to be an isomorphism. is two different gadgets. Or what you can do is take K series with finite coefficients, and then you go to the limit, and you have something. Okay? You can have the same question for GW. Not take real manifolds. You take GR of X. It's also far to minimize, so it looks hopeless. Okay? But what I'm saying now is that the map from W of X to WR of X, so that's a theorem, is almost an isomorphism. So in other words, you have an algebraic invariant, which is W of X, and a topological invariant, W of X, and I claim they're almost the same. What I mean by almost is that the kernel and co-kernel of alpha are two primary torsion groups. And the order is bounded by an explicit function of the dimension. Exactly. So the dimension is 8m, 8m plus 1, 8m plus 2. Then the order is bounded by 14, 16 to the m. If d is equal to 8m plus 3, 8m plus 4 is bounded by 14, by 16 over m plus 1. And finally, for 8m plus 5, 8m plus 6, 8m plus 7 is bounded by 16, 4, 16 power m plus 1. Okay. This is what I mean by almost an isomorphism. And in fact, I can add something. For curves, it's an isomorphism. So if x is a smooth projective curve, real curve, then W of X is isomorphic to WR of X. Maybe I give an example. The example is the following. If X is a curve, smooth theorem, so it's a smooth projective curve of genus G. Real. Almost everything is real in my talk. It's real talk. So, if the space of real points is empty, then W of X is isomorphic to Z mod 4 plus Z2 power G. Or Z mod 2 power G plus 2. The ambiguity depends on the cohomology class, which I don't want to emphasize. And if XR is non-empty, then the Witt group is morphic to Z power nu plus Z2 to the G where nu is a number of connected components. Oh, yes, yes, many, many. Ah, no. Are you mean Peter? Oh, yes, of course. You take a land space, for example. Yeah, well, there are many examples where you can have odd torsion. Yes. Yeah. In fact, this result is not new. It has been proved by Knebusch using algebraic methods. But we find it again by topological methods. OK. So, yes, yes, we again need explicit elements. Maybe I shall, so this is our theorem. Maybe I shall explain how this theorem is coming from. Yes, yes. But this was known in the 70s already. This was done by Knebusch. There was a lot of activities on, maybe I should say something. In the 70s, many people work on real algebraic varieties. For example, Coyote-Len. Mahé. Parimala. Knebusch, of course. And there was a lot of results in this direction. But somehow the theory was forgotten. And Chuck and me, we tried to give a new vision on the subject using recent results by Wojcicki and Rost. That was our idea. OK. So what is the main idea of the proof? The main idea of the proof is to mimic Rost and Wojcicki work, of course, by working in the Hermitian category instead of working in the binaire category. So in other words, we take the spectrum as in K-theory. We can define spectra for Hermitian K-theory. I have done this a long time ago, but most recent work has been done by Marco Schichting in a series of papers. And following the work of Waldhausen, Thomasson, Quillen, he succeeded to define a spectrum GW of X. So this is a spectrum for Hermitian K-theory. So the homotopy groups of this spectrum are the higher Hermitian K-groups. For example, just to give an idea, if X is a spectrum of a ring, say a commutative ring, for example, then this GWN. Well, OK. Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry. There is spectrum in algebraic topology, spectrum in algebraic geometry, and they have the same name. OK, sorry. There is a spectrum in functional analysis also, yes? OK, so GWN of X is just homotopy groups of BO of A plus, Quillen plus construction. But instead of applying to general linear group, you apply it to the orthogonal group. So that's an idea of what this GWN is. Okay. And okay. And now you can try to prove the result of which I said before. Of course, sorry, I should say also that we can define a real, that's more easy, a real topological spectrum. Okay, and pi n is GRN, which is, if you like, KOG of the n suspension of X plus. If you are a topologist. And of course, there is a relation between algebra and topology, as we said in K-theory. Maybe I should put more space. Here, X is a space with involution. Of course, if you take an algebra, you need an algebra with anti-involution. Yes, yes. So in my statement here, AA is an algebra with anti-involution. In the non-commutative framework. But here, I'm in commutative framework, because X is a variety. So I want to mimic Ross and Voivodsky work. So of course, a natural candidate is to take the map between these two spectra. So I have GW of X, GR of X, and the relative spectrum. GR relative. And the theorem is a homotopy fiber. So in other words, I have, if I take homotopy groups, I get an exact sequence pi n, well, GW n relative of X, GWN of X. GRN of X, and so on. Okay? So what theorem now? Theorem, which has been proved by many people, Beric, myself, Schisting, and Ostvar is going to appear in advances, said exactly the same theorem from algebraic K-theory is valid for Hermitian K-theory with a small restriction, is that GRN of GWN, sorry, the GWN relative of X is uniquely infinity two divisible. There is a twist here. Not p divisible, but two divisible. Okay. And the way to prove the theorem is to show, in fact, that Hermitian K-theory, if you look at p-adically, is the same as algebraic K-theory. So, in fact, this theorem is a consequence of another theorem, which is that GW completed at two completion is the same as the algebraic K-theory spectrum K, so Z2 of X, HZ2, HG. Well, that's a technical definition. GG is a group with two elements. And I take the homotopy fixed point, which is maps, it's just map from EG, equivalent map from EG to the K-theory spectrum. That's it was this statement was conjectured by Bruce Williams, and we succeeded to prove it in general for this case. Okay. So starting with theorem, you can deduce this theorem from algebraic K-theory. Okay. So finally, we use again Voivodsky-Ross. Okay. Okay. Now, from this theorem, how can we prove the theorem I stated before? Here I have to use a theorem of Brumfield. I forgot Brumfield, by the way, in the list. We use the theorem of Brumfield. I should say Brumfield and Mayes theorem. This was proved in the 70s. That the V group and you have a map from the V group of X to the V group, real V group of the space of real points. Okay? Which is just KO. KO of X1. So what Brumfield proved, and Mae, that this map is an isomorphism mode two torsion. So if you call beta this map, Kerr beta and Kerr beta are two primary torsion groups. But they have no control of the two torsion. Yes? Yeah, no. No, no, wait. Because it's XR. But there is another one which is WR of X. And you have a factorization. Okay. And you can prove this gamma here is also an isomorphism of two torsion. So in fact, working.
But I'm confused by the example of curve.
Yes, why?
Because then when you set up here for the length, you still have two torsion.
Yes. Yeah, but that's okay. I said the kernel and co-kernel are two primary torsion groups. There are no free parts. So there's no contradiction. Now the difference between my Brumfield-Mayes theorem and what I'm saying is that our invariant is more subtle because you're going to WR. Okay, so when XR is empty, you get nothing. Okay, so this is a theorem which is very deep. You use a real spectra and use essentially Stone-Weierstrass theorem. That's the consequence of this. So now if you put together Brumfield-Mayes theorem and this general theorem we prove with Marco Schlichting and the others, then you get the first theorem. Why? Because there is a remark. There is still an ingredient. It's not completely obvious. Yeah, there is still something I forgot to say. It's about periodicity, which is very important. So let me explain this. How much time I have left? Okay. There must be some bot periodicity here somewhere. And this is, in fact, one of the key ingredients. So let me explain. Yes, exactly. You know the proof now. There is an algebraic remark. An algebraic, simple, but fundamental remark. Is that there is a map from GW of X to W of X, which is a quotient map, but there is a map backwards, which is not a splitting, almost a splitting. You send a class of a E phi, where phi is a bilinear form, to E phi minus E minus phi. It's easy to show that it's defined on the quotient. And the composition is a multiplication by two. This means that up to a group of order two, W of X is isomorphic to the antisymmetric part of the quantity group with respect to the evolution, which ends E phi to E minus phi. So for simplicity, I will identify these two groups, or just to explain the argument. And now I use my theorem above to show that JWN minus relative is infinitely two divisible, uniquely two divisible, because it's a subgroup of something which is infinitely two divisible. Okay. But on the other hand, according to Brumfield's theorem, it's a two primary torsion group. Therefore, it is zero. Okay? So I prove not exactly what I wanted. I prove that WN is isomorphic. Well, sorry, for n bigger, I forgot, d minus 2. So what I prove is another theorem. I prove that WN is isomorphic to WN WRN up to a group of order 2 if n is bigger than d minus 2. But now I have to go back to W0. Then I use Bode periodicity. Okay. And what is Bode periodicity? Of course, it's not exactly Bode periodicity because it's a periodicity in this algebraic context, but the idea is the same. There are many proofs, of course, of Bode periodicity. And the proof I like the most is the following. How do you prove that KUN, for example, is periodic of period 2? Well, if you can find Bode elements, U in KU2 of the point, and V in KU minus 2 of the point, so that U cap V is 1 in KU0 of the point. Then to define the Bode map, you define a map from KUN to KUN plus 2 with a cap product with U and backwards, which is a cap product with V. And then it's an easy exercise to show it is an isomorphism, because that's my favorite proof. Okay. But you can play the same. What? It works. Yes, it works modulate, well, of course. Of course, I'm hiding here. I think a lot of technology because I have to define KUN for a negative, okay, which I've not done yet. But it's the same idea. So you want to prove that. So the theorem is that WN, there is a map from WN to WN plus 8, X, and the map backwards. Okay, so that's a cup product is multiplied by 16. Okay. And for this, you need to define these Bode elements. Okay. And this requires, I don't know if I have time. Yes, I have 10 minutes, I can explain. So in other words, or maybe I should, instead of giving the proof, which is a standard, maybe I should add some words, which is more original. You see, so far I've taken all the symmetric binary form. You can ask, so another question is what happens if we take antisymmetric bilinear forms instead of symmetric forms? Okay. Of course, the technology looks the same. In fact, Marco Schichting defining also GW in this context as well. But there is a twist, because what is a GR here? Okay, what is the analog of real vector bundle? You see, so it's not completely obvious, you see? And the analog of GR is what I call KRH, H is a quaternion of X. So what is KRH of X? It's in fact twisted K theory. But a very simple example. Because you can take X is a space with involution, and H, you take the bundle of algebra, and you take modules over this bundle of algebra. Okay. So it's the same definition as Atiyah, except that you take on H the involution, which is I minus I and J minus J. Okay. And so the same theorem is true, which is W minus antisymmetric forms, antisymmetric, is a morphic to the co-kernel of kr of x. We can put krc if you want, to krh. So the same mod, I mean, not exactly this. I see that I have a map alpha, and kr alpha, and co-kr alpha are two primary torsion groups with the same hypothesis. Okay, I would like to conclude with also a computation, which is how to compute this WR. In fact, we need this computation for the curves. And this is also a variant of Bode-Pardee density. So the question, computation question, is how to compute. There is no point, of course, to define an invariant which we cannot compute. Okay. So we need some tools to compute it. And I remind you that WR is a co-kernel of the map from K of X to GR of X, which is KOG of X. Okay, so sigma. So WR is a co-kernel of sigma. So we need to define the relative term in order to be able to compute this co-kernel. And the theorem is that the homotopy fiber is also KOG theorem. So in fact, there is a linear sequence, KOG of X cross R, and so on. KR1, and so on. So in other words, KR theory appears as a particular case of KOG theory, because it fits to an exact sequence. And the proof, I mean, I ask Atiyah whether he knows this exact sequence. He doesn't know. So it seems new. So the theorem is that you have an exact sequence. And in fact, the way to prove this exact sequence is to use topological Hermitian case theory and Clifford algebra. It's very surprising. And of course, you can do the same with the symplectic with antisymmetric bilinear forms, and you have also an exact sequence with the kr of x. The bit group is a co-kernel of sigma. Yes. For a field is zero. Yeah, so it's not interesting. Okay. But it's different for a scheme or for algebraic varieties. You can have something which is not trivial. So it's yes, I forgot. Yes, you are right. By anti-involution, T in minus T. It's otherwise, it's not interesting. Yes, you are right. It acts by anti-involution, T in minus T. Yes. So the way you put sequence is not completely obvious. I mean, you have to use both periodicity. Yes. I mean, we have two proofs of this theorem. One proof which is very sophisticated using Clifford algebra. Another one which is more naive, it was our first proof, is to distinguish two cases. And if I recommend this as an exercise, take G acting trivially on X and G acting freely on X. And then you can find two proofs, and then you combine the two proofs to get one. But it's not so interesting. The best proof is to use Clifford algebra. And you have the same exact sequence with this antisymmetric bilinear form. But instead of having KOG here, you have KRH. Okay. So you have an exact sequence, KR of X, but this group KRH is a little bit mysterious because it's a twisted case theory. But we know by Atiyah and Siegel there is a way to compute twisted case theory by spectral sequences, or there are some way to compute that. And this K of X appears not as twisted K theory, very strange, because it's not, in twisted K theory, you consider bundles of central simple algebras. But C is not central. It's a real algebra which is not central. So we need a slight generalization of twisted K theory, which doesn't appear here, because H is central simple. Okay, maybe I should stop.
Enlève 5 minutes de
Oui, j'aurais pu parler de votre précision, les gens étaient fatigués, donc j'ai pu m'arrêter.